Hi, this is Larry Phelps from Solbrick. I would like to share with you what I call my 7 ingredients to a successful document management system project. Over 10 years ago, I volunteered for assignment. I had no idea how to start. It took me back to the days in high school algebra class. If the teacher turned and began scribbling a long equation on the blackboard, you knew that when she turned around and faced the class, she was looking for a victim to call on to solve the problem. And that was something you never wanted to volunteer for. The assignment I mistakenly volunteered for was helping my client select an electronic document management system. Their microfiche machine had broken, and they were looking to replace it with a new document management system. Maybe you are in the exact same place I was those many years ago. You are responsible for selecting a document management system, and you too do not know where to begin. I began my task by talking to vendors of these products and their references, and I learned very little. It wasn't until I remembered that in life we learn from our failures that I began making progress. So I began searching for failed electronic document management projects, and that is when I really began to learn. From the lessons I learned from these failures, I came up with what I call the 7 ingredients of a successful electronic document management project. If you use this recipe of ingredients, you will find the result is a successful implementation of an electronic document management system. Ingredient 1, easy to learn and use. The product you select must be easy to learn and easy to use, otherwise your project will fail. Why, you ask? I believe there are 2 reasons. First reason, people are either too busy or too lazy to learn a complicated program, or people will take the path of least resistance. In either case, most people will either go back to their old ways or they will go to the one person that has taken the time to learn the product. Another important aspect to this ingredient is that it is important for the user to easily find the document that they are seeking, no matter what they know about the document. That means the product you choose should have a good search engine and allow index searches as well as full text searches. Ingredient 2, non-proprietary. The product you select cannot have anything proprietary in it. By that I mean technology unique to the manufacturer. Many of the early electronic document management products were loaded with proprietary technology. They had special drives, hardware, databases, image file formats that were all proprietary. Today we even see this in many products. These products have modified TIFF formats or some other file format, such as an ever-changing PDF format. Also, many vendors offer an add-on image module to their product, such as a CRM product. These imaging modules, for the most part, are very limited in their capabilities and are often only useful for documents related to the vendor's product. And these often use proprietary formats or methods to attach documents to their systems. Having these proprietary items make it difficult to upgrade the system, integrate to another system, use for other documents in the organization, or migrate to a completely new EDM system. Ingredient 3, scalable. Any product you select should be able to grow as your needs grow. Many of the early systems came in certain user units such as 10, 25, 50, or 100. So if you were at 24 users and wanted to add just one more user, you had a huge expense. Also, many systems have limitations on the number of users, the number of pages it can handle. The system you select should be able to expand from one user to any number of users that you need and add features such as batch processing or workflow if and when you need it. Ingredient 4, adaptable. The product you select and the way that you implement it in your environment must be able to adapt to the way people are familiar with working. That means that the way we store things on paper should be similar to the way we store them electronically. For example, if we store accounts payable documents on paper filed by company last name, then in the imaging system, you should be able to see the AP documents stored in electronic folders alphabetically by company name. You should not have to change the way you do business to fit the software. Ingredient 5, open architecture. Electronic document management systems are very powerful and useful to an organization as a standalone unit, but the value grows exponentially when you are able to integrate it with other existing systems such as accounting or contact management system. I suggest picking a system that runs on an open platform such as Microsoft SQL and has programmers' toolkits and other utilities that allow it to link to other databases. One city that I work with realized the power of integration when they integrated their document imaging system with their GIS system, their permitting program, and their online credit processing system. Now they were able to go to a map of the city and click on a parcel and quickly see all the documents associated with that parcel, including permits, correspondence, payments, or building permits. Ingredient 6, long-term vendor. When I was doing my research on failed EDM projects, I was surprised to find a large number of failed projects were caused by the vendor no longer supporting the product the organization was using. Looking deeper, the companies that dropped their EDM products were not the small entrepreneurial companies, but were large, solid companies that had their major focus in some other product areas, such as copiers or computer equipment. These companies saw electronic document management systems as a small distraction to their large corporate portfolio, but to the users, it was their key product that housed all their vital company documents. The users felt betrayed and left hanging with no recourse but to find a way to migrate their data and documents to a new system. Today, I'm seeing a new trend where large corporations are purchasing small companies that produce document management systems and are migrating their customer base to one product. Today, I tell people, find an electronic document management vendor whose main focus is document imaging and has been in the business for more than 10 years. Ingredient 7, a phased approach. I also found that organizations that tried to implement everything all at once were more likely to fail than organizations that broke the project into several phases and systematically moved through their organization. One reason that these all-or-nothing type projects fail is that nothing actually is completed because time is divided amongst all the departments. The other reason projects like this fail is that people basically hate change, and when you change everything all at once, they push back. The best way to implement a document management system in an organization is by evolution rather than revolution. I hope you found this information helpful. You can go to my website listed below and find more articles like this.